No match, no nothing.
What was that grant for?
To hook up the SAU building to this. We've been very aggressive with grants and stuff, and that's like the electricity. I'm looking for, there's a new grant out that this doesn't, it involves production of electricity, no solar, no solar thermal, or it's just for hydro or any of that, and that's what I'm looking for to pay for this. Because, you know, and like I tell the kids, my generation has screwed this oil prices up 3 times, and we haven't done anything about it. Now, I had a class in here last week, and all of a sudden, they were asking some great questions. And all of a sudden, it dawned on me, and I put the blame on myself, so that's okay. But I said, it's up to you guys to change that. And the question was what the payback was, and I said, it really doesn't make any difference what the payback is. It's the right thing to do. You know, it may not pay today, it may not pay next week, but 20 years from now, somebody's going to stop sometime, you know. This thing's all paid for because we've had the gumption to go out and be different. You know, take a chance. It's unproven technology. Take a chance and do the right thing. The right thing doesn't have to pay today, right? And just because, and this economy and this country, everything is driven by the dollar bill. You know, the long-term dollar bill is there too. You know, if we went to insulate our homes, we know it isn't going to pay this year or next year, but we know over the course of 20 years, it's a good investment. And the same thing with all this other technology.
You have a big plant here with the two schools. For somebody just looking at maybe something half this size, does it still, do the economics work out as well?
Sisters of the Holy Cross, right up here between Franklin and Alex Ray, common man. Alex was down 3-4 years ago when he was opening this plant. He has a boiler. It looks exactly the same thing. It's half the size. This is 5 million BTU. This is 2,500. It does little small residential buildings. But having said that, in a 100,000 square foot building, we've had all kinds of surveys done, and 100,000 square foot building, pellet stove is the best thing for a residential area. Pellet furnace, pellet anything. The only thing with the pellets, when you get commercial by any means, it's a process product. There's 5 times the BTU out of a pellet that is of a chip. They're competing with us for the price of the chips, also they use them. But having said that, processing costs money, so they're getting 5 times the BTU out of it. So the infrastructure is that much smaller. 100,000 square foot building, commercial building, for $300,000 you can roll a pellet furnace in, a silo, and all the stuff like tie it in, the controls, and be heating your building. Whereas this plant would cost you $1.5 million to put into that building. In 6 years, that pellet stove is paid for. In 11 years, the chip plant is paid for. The big difference is that 20 years, the chips will save you hundreds of thousands of dollars because of processing fees and all that. It's a natural product that comes right in, you're getting it, you know.